हेलो वर्ल्ड, इट्स राहुल। वेलकम बैक गाइस टू मशीन लर्निंग ट्यूटोरियल। सो गाइस, एज आई हैव प्रॉमिस्ड दैट आई वुड कम अप विद हाउ कैन वी अप्लाई सपोर्ट वेक्टर मशीन ऑन नॉन लीनियरली सेपरेबल डेटा यूजिंग कर्नल ट्रिक। सो हियर इट इज SVM पार्ट 4। टिल नाउ वी हैव ऑलरेडी फेमिलियर विद हाइपरप्लेन, मार्जिन, मार्जिनल डिस्टेंस, सपोर्ट वैक्टर्स, क्वाड्रेटिक ऑप्टिमाइजर इंक्लूडिंग बोथ प्राइमल लैग्रेंजियन एंड डुअल ऑप्टिमाइजर। We have understood how mathematically we can implement all of these. So guys, if you haven't watched my previous video on basic intuition of SVM, I would suggest you to go and check that video. I have attached video links in the description. So guys, we have seen that if we have data as shown on the left of the screen, we can create hyperplane with maximum marginal distance between two classes. And we are familiar that how can we generate these lines. But what if we have a data as shown on the right of the screen, where we don't have clear separating hyperplane between two classes? So how are we going to solve this problem? So if this is your concern, then definitely you have landed at right place. So guys, let's quickly start support vector machine part 4. So guys, let's say here we are considering x-axis as x1 feature and y-axis as x2 feature. So let's calculate vector points for all these data points. And if I talk about this point, then vector point will be 2 at x-axis, that is x1 feature, and 2 at y-axis, that is x2 feature. So we can map each point with axis as shown on the screen. Let's consider red point as class A vector and green points as class B vector with us. So guys, as we have these vectors with us and we already know that we have to transform this data in higher dimension so that we can create separable hyperplane between these classes. We will find out a non-linear mapping function, that is phi, through which we can transform this data into new feature space, and thus we will be able to create separating hyperplane. Now question arises, how can we get this phi value, or what is this phi value? So let's quickly jump into kernel trick. So the linear classifier only depends on dot products. So let's define some function ker of point x1 and x2 as just being the dot products. And if I map a data point to some higher dimensional space, so my function phi will be mapped to x to phi of x. So the dot product of ker of x1, x2 would become phi of x1 transpose into phi of x2. So here, ker is the similarity function that corresponds to an inner product of higher dimensional space. So guys, if you haven't understood this, then it's not a problem. We will understand this through an example where we can mathematically solve our problem. Now let's say we have a mapping function as shown on the screen. And if we look into class A, then we can find out that under root of x1 square plus x2 square is less than or equal to 4. So there will not be any transformation. But if you see class B, then this will be transformed into different space, because the value of under root of x1 square plus x2 square for class B is greater than or equal to 4. Just to add one thing, that under root of x1 square plus x2 square is nothing but the Euclidean distance. Let's apply this function to class B. So first vector is 4, 0, and if we substitute x1 as 4 and x2 as 0 in the function, then our phi will be 20, 24. Now we have transformed this vector from original vector 4, 0 to new vector position 20, 24. Similarly, we can transform each and every data points in class B as shown on the screen. So guys, we have transformed vectors for class B. And if we try to represent this on graph, then we can find out the difference between vectors what we had earlier and vectors what we get after transformation. So here, if you can see, we can conclude that class A has remained in its position, whereas class B has been shifted to some other space. So now we can easily find out the separable hyperplane, as we have transformed our non-linear separable data into linear separable data. And it's related to linear SVM, what we have already covered in last videos. So by getting this knowledge, we can create hyperplane for this data as well. So guys, Now we have finished support vector machine by covering basic intuition of hyperplane, margin, optimization, linear separable or non-linear separable data, and kernel tricks. So if you have any questions related to this, you can ask me in comment section or you can reach out to me through email. I have mentioned all my details in description. Thank you guys for your time. Do like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Happy learning and stay safe.